expedience behind it. He announced his support for Kavanaugh only after Senator Susan Collins had already given Kavanaugh the final vote he needed to pass the Senate. The vote could help bolster Manchin's reputation as independent from Democratic leadership, a key survival trait in deep red West Virginia. But so far, his vote hasn't quieted Republican attacks on him. Manchin's opponent, West Virginia Attorney General Patrick Morrissey, slammed his last-minute decision as, quote, gutless in a tweet Friday. Kavanaugh's confirmation process has been particularly divisive for the Senate. President Trump's first Supreme Court pick, Justice Neil Gorsuch, was confirmed with support from both Manchin and Heitkamp, as well as Democratic Senator Joe Donnelly from Indiana.
Let's explore the big Kavanaugh vote more. Earlier today, I spoke with Anthony Marcum. He's a research associate at the R Street Institute, which is a nonprofit libertarian think tank. To start, I asked him what Kavanaugh's confirmation means for the Supreme Court moving forward.
For many people do view this as going to be a solid 5-4 majority block for conservatives. However, Kennedy, for many, was seen as a moderate justice because he joined the more liberal bloc in cases concerning gay rights, abortion, and affirmative action, for example. But we can even look to the last term that overall, Justice Kennedy was a conservative justice. He was the majority opinion for Citizens United, which regulated campaign spending by organizations. In his final year, he sided with the conservative majority in almost every case, including cases about voter registration, labor unions, and most notably, President Trump's travel ban. So although he was seen as a moderate justice, he was a conservative for the majority of his career, and Justice Kavanaugh, by some, will be seen as fitting that block.
One of the big issues of concern for both parties, left and right, is the issue of abortion and where Judge Kavanaugh might stand on Roe versus Wade. What would it take for that to even rise up to the Supreme Court? What has to happen even for Kavanaugh's vote to even matter?
Well, for Justice Kavanaugh's vote to matter, of course, a case would have to go through the federal courts. It would start at the district court, going up to the relevant circuit court. Then ultimately, the Supreme Court would have to accept the case by granting what's called certiorari. Notably, to grant certiorari, it would only take four justices. So, for example, even if you didn't have a 5-4 majority of justices wanting to take a case, only four justices could accept it, and it would be heard by the court. So if Justice Kavanaugh were interested in hearing a case, for example, it would only take three other justices to accept such a case.
Some Democrats, after Kavanaugh's confirmation, have floated the idea of impeachment to get him off the Supreme Court, which has never happened before with a justice. Only one other justice has actually even been impeached but wasn't removed. Do you think if they went that route, do you think it would be a smart move or politically dangerous?
This is
assuming that they won back the House in November.
Sure, yeah. And you're correct that impeachment has been something you've seen floated by a lot on the political left. And of course, if the Democrats did take the House of Representatives after this November election, that's something they could do. The one problem that they would encounter in the Senate is that it would need 2/3 majority to impeach someone in the Senate. And the problem would be obviously that it looks like we're not going to have that sort of a majority for a very long time, especially this election. So, for example, if the Democrats did impeach at the House side, the Senate side, it would be very, very partisan, very, very controversial, and something that we may even see more fiery than his confirmation process.
Let's take a look at midterms now. Some of the key votes: Democrat Joe Manchin voted yes for Kavanaugh. Democrat Heidi Heitkamp voted no. Who do you think, in your opinion, is being helped or hurt by their vote come November?
As much of it as this is a punt, but really it's wait and see. For Senator Joe Manchin, he's in a very conservative state where he has a very strong conservative opponent. For Heidi Heitkamp, similar. What we'll have to see is, based on their vote, whether the public factors that in as their choice for the fall when it comes to these Senate races.
And with Heitkamp, she's in a state that she's trailing in the polls also, mm-hmm. and President Trump won North Dakota by quite a lot in the 2016 election. Now, Justice Kavanaugh was confirmed 50-48. Only one other justice in Supreme Court history had a closer vote, and you have to actually go back to the 19th century for that. What does this tell you, this close vote? What does this tell you about the state of politics right now?
Well, we are seeing a trend in judicial confirmations at the Supreme Court level becoming more and more partisan. You can look back to Justice Antonin Scalia and Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, where both were confirmed by overwhelming majorities. And again, you can see it narrowing more and more. For Justice Kavanaugh, we'll see whether this becomes the rule or the exception.
We ended that conversation about close votes, some more perspective. In the 1980s, Justice Kennedy, the vote was 97-0. Justice Scalia, 98-0. In 1991, Clarence Thomas was 52-48. And the most recent one before Kavanaugh last year, Neil Gorsuch, 54-45. Several communities across the U.S. want to change the focus of Columbus Day. Instead, they want to focus on North America's indigenous population. And a new app is helping.
How much do you know about the Native people who lived where you do now? This app aims to teach users the indigenous history of their area. It's called Native Land. Users input a zip code and a map.